Thank you. So what I want to do is actually start with a slide I showed last year, which is the total AI software market at $596 billion. This was the largest market to date in software. However, IDC revised this number this year to $791 billion. The growth in this market alone in the last year is larger than the entire analytics platform market, right? So still one of the largest markets today. However, as Rowan mentioned, and I think even Jim talked about, the approach that many companies are taking are to put in place these data lakes and try to then build kind of departmental AI applications against those data lakes. The issue is it's not reusable, it's not scalable, and at the end of the day, you have an AI application, but is it showing value? So the way that C3 thinks about its product roadmap, how we build product, how we decide to build product, is all around value, right? What is the value across the value chain in the industry that you're in? What is the value of revenue intelligence? What is the value of supplier management or supply network risk? And how do you actually achieve that value with AI? And in doing so, this is how we, with our customers, have actually started to develop the suites of applications that we've developed, whether it's in supply chain, reliability, sustainability, defense and intelligence, state and local, financial services, CRM, and oil and gas. Working with our customers, trying to understand the actual value that these applications have, building the first version, then building the second version and the third version, and always focused on, are we realizing the value at the customer? I want to dig into a little bit more into one example area and how we build product, and that's really in supply chain. Jim talked about it. You're going to hear more from other customers as well. But in the supply chain space, there's, you know, AI is becoming a very big deal. However, the underlying technology is not set up for AI. Time series, kind of machine learning features, the models and the applications themselves. And that's really where C3 comes in. We can sit on top of these existing systems and help you drive the entire value chain around supply chain. Rather than point solutions that might be solving a problem, we're looking at a common data foundation and analytics layer with machine learning and how we're going to actually then improve. So whether you're looking at order delays, schedule conflicts, OTIF, we're thinking about how do you make this predictive in nature using AI. And at the end of the day, it's not only AI that we're looking at. We're looking at what's the best technology to solve the problem that we have for the workflow that we're solving. So it could be optimization in this case, where we're using not just AI, but we're using optimization at scale for things like production schedule optimization or demand uncertainty. And at the end of the day, with our platform, we're looking at how can you actually redesign the entire supply chain and in real time be able to execute on that. And that is how you realize economic benefit, right? So although there may be a lot of AI applications or models out in the corporation today, are you realizing the value of actually the deployments that you're executing? And in all of our applications, that's what we're looking at. And within the applications, we're actually measuring that as well, right? So an important element of how we approach our deployments and our customers. And as we know, there's lots of technologies out there today, kind of point solutions that are trying to solve these different problems. But we've taken a very different approach, right? So we've spent the last 14 years trying to think through and build this next generation technology stack, that sits on top of cloud infrastructure and letting the cloud providers continue innovate in what they're doing. The platform services that they're actually executing, whether it's queuing or streaming or persistent stores, we're letting those kind of continue to evolve and innovate. And what we're building is kind of an AI application development platform that allows you to rapidly develop AI applications. And whether you're a data scientist, you can use Jupyter Lab to interface with the platform. If you're a system integrator, you can use our Canvas low-code tool. Or if you're a developer, we have a VS Code interface, all against the same platform. On top of this platform, we're thinking about the business analyst and how they're going to actually execute against that. So Tom mentioned Ex Machina earlier, but our Ex Machina product is a no-code analytics platform that allows you to do analytics, allows you to do BI, and allows you to do machine learning and AutoML at scale. But it sits on top of the same platform. So as a business analyst or citizen data scientist, what you've built can go right back into the platform, available to the applications, available to the developers and data scientists to actually use that in their next app that they're developing. And then the applications themselves, right? So these are complete workflow-based applications that sit on top of the platform, accessible by Ex Machina to be able to do analytics and ad hoc querying and drive the overall business process. And now, generative. We're creating kind of a natural language interface to all of our applications to allow you to ask a simple question, get the answers that you need across the stack. And this is really how we, drive our roadmap, really across these four categories. And I think we're going to spend time today walking through each one of these in the roadmap that we're developing. What's important, though, is this has been a journey. We spent the last 14 years building out this platform, from the model-driven architecture to data integration and correlation to IoT to AI and ML many, many years ago, to the developer experience, multi-cloud. And then with all the learnings and the complex deployments that we've had with our customers, we refined that platform one more time. And thanks to our customers, we were ranked this year as a leader in the AIML platform space, number one in strategy, product vision, application tools, market approach, application accelerators, runtime, security, data features. So an overall leader, this was the first time this was published. We've also been ranked by Forrester as a leader in industrial IoT platforms, ranked by Omdia as a leader in enterprise ML, a leader by IDC in energy digital solutions. We've been ranked a leader by Bloomberg, by LNS Research, and Constellation again recently put us on the short list for AI ML platforms. Over the last year, we've surveyed transformed participants. We've had over 500 product roadmap sessions and feedback workshops. We've had 350 CSAT surveys to our customers. We've looked at over 800 training reports. We've had 400 meetings. We've looked at all of our Zendesk tickets and all of the community posts. And with that, we've been developing the roadmap for the next year, really across the categories that I'm showing here.
I'm so excited to get to show off some of these new product innovations in action. So, to tell you about the story, I'm going to use Acme Corp as a notional example. Acme is a large multinational wind turbine manufacturer, and we'll walk through three different users who all collaborate using C3 AI applications to improve business outcomes. We'll start with Maria, the global VP of supply chain, moving on to Theo, a supply analyst on Maria's team, and then finally end with Armando, a data analyst who uses Ex Machina. So let's start with Maria. Maria has been on a journey to improve supplier performance for Acme over the past couple of years, but she wants to make Acme Corp a leader in supply chain management. So she uses C3 AI supply chain suite to change the way they manage their supply chain. In C3 AI supply chain suite, her team has already integrated various disparate data sources, starting with their ERP systems, a collection of various SAP and Oracle instances from across the world, their supplier relationship management software, external data feeds from things like Dun & Bradstreet or IHS Market for commodities and market information, AIS data for vessel tracking and port congestion, international news feeds and weather forecasts, amongst many other data sources. All of these data are pulled together to provide her and her team a contextualized view of what's going on in their operations in near real time. So Maria starts her day by asking important questions that are at the top of her mind. She'll start by asking about what's the overall current performance by region that is impacting her supply chain. Previously, this type of question might take her to various Power BI dashboards, sifting through a number of different sources, or reaching out to an analyst to prepare a spreadsheet that might take hours or days to get back to her. Here, right away, she immediately sees that North America is the underperforming region, along with relevant search results that she might choose to dive into from various other applications available to her, as well as the C3AI apps and news sources. So she follows up with another question to dig more deeply into what's going on in North America. She sees what is the top worst performing supplier, in this case, Bearing Distributors, along with other application links. And here she dives into a news article indicating that there's a supply chain squeeze in North America that is most likely impacting her business. With that, Maria has the information armed and ready to go talk to Theo so he can take further action to mitigate potential issues from suppliers like Bearing Distributors that could be flowing into their North America plants. So Theo, the supply manager responsible for making sure that parts and goods arrive to manufacturing sites and distribution centers in North America on time, also starts his day in C3 Generative AI. He follows up with Maria's inquiry with a question of his own in order to dig into what's going on with Bearing Distributors. Like Maria, he's presented with a simple user interface that presents the top purchase orders that are either already delayed or predicted to be delayed by the AI algorithms. In this case, he can dive directly into C3AI supply network risk, his application for mitigating and responding to these potential issues. On the order detail page, he's presented with a summary of this purchase order. All of this information is being pulled from his MRP system and from the supplier and transportation systems. Previously, he maybe would have had to call a supplier or his transportation company to understand, where is this shipment? Just answer the question, where's my stuff? In C3AI Supply Network Risk, he has that visibility all the way down at the part level tracking. And here he can see what is the progress of the shipment all the way from order creation to where it is now sitting on a ship somewhere in the Pacific Ocean. To understand why the AI is predicting that this order is likely to be delayed, he goes into the AI explainability page. Here he can see in the dashed white line that the predicted lead time is dynamically updating as the order has progressed over time, and it's increasing over time. The evidence package is further explaining that there's port-to-port lead time issues, and he wants to understand in more detail what's really going on and what could he actually do to mitigate this predicted delay. So with that, he dives into the advanced analysis capability, where he sees a geospatial view as well as the network graph of how this order is moving throughout his supply chain. In the container side panel, he's presented with an AI recommendation that reminds him to increase the priority of this container. It needs to be processed first when it arrives at LA. He goes ahead and takes action with this recommendation, which directly updates into his transportation and supplier management system. So now the port knows that they need to increase the priority and process it through Customs and Border Patrol first. He also dives into the distribution center, where he sees an alert at Joliet, where the shipment is eventually headed. Not only is he presented with the estimated stockout risk for the next month, because all of this information is pulled together with the material information for this distribution center where the shipment is headed, but he's also presented with a few options. How can he mitigate this potential stockout? He has two available containers, that one in New York and one in Houston, as well as understand the trade-offs. And he knows that the AI algorithms are already incorporating that network graph, which he could further expand in this view if he wants to see if there's any potential downstream risks. In this case, there are none, and he can choose to accept a recommendation to avoid the stockout altogether. In just a few clicks, he's not only identified an increasing lead time and potential issue upcoming with a distribution center, but he's also taken two actions to mitigate the stockout and avoid a major outage at a distribution center. With that, he hands over to Armando. Theo knows that there's probably other suppliers and other purchase orders that are facing the same supply squeeze in LA, the port of LA, and international shipments coming from China. And he wants to make sure that other supply managers have that same visibility. So Armando dives in with C3AI Ex Machina embedded within the supply network risk application. This is part of his user experience of the entire C3AI supply chain suite. So Armando has a project that he's already created. It's a template that's unifying various disparate data sources, and he can dive into the detailed view to start making edits. The template is already doing all of the data wrangling and pre-processing to combine information of historical purchase orders, open purchase orders, supplier risk ratings, weather forecast, all of the information that Theo indicated, you know, might be impacting these purchase order risks, and Armando wants to take further action. So the first thing he does is he just steps into a graph visualization to understand, are these the right suppliers that he's looking at? Is it the right time frame that he wants? And maybe it's a simple problem that, you know, Theo didn't notice right away. He can look at all of these graph visualizations to see what might be going on with the suppliers at large. He decides that, yes, this is the right data set, and he's ready to start building a new machine learning model. Ex Machina automatically applies AutoML so that the machine learning models automatically train dozens of models so that he can choose the best performing model automatically to apply to this pipeline. He sees that the top model has relatively good performance, and he scrolls down to see a little bit more detail about the, what features are top contributing and make sure that he agrees with the predictions that might be coming from this trained model. He sees that the top feature contributions are things like supplier risk ratings and the international origin of the supplier, and he agrees that he's ready to use this model in production. So he goes ahead and brings this model into his pipeline. Ex Machina saves the trained model in a model registry so that it becomes available for the inference step. In the previous step, he was using historical purchase orders to train that model on historical data where he knew that there were prior delays. And now in this case, he's ready to drag it in as a trained model to start making new inferences. With this step, Armando is generating completely novel and new insights that were previously unavailable, all in a no-code interface. He's making, he's cleaning up data and he's post-processing the predictions so that it can become very intuitive and user-friendly in a dashboard. As Binu mentioned earlier, we've introduced stories as a concept in C3 AI Ex Machina. These stories allow Armando to share these insights now back with the supply managers like Theo to be available in as part of the application and in a dashboard-like interface. So now Armando has trained this machine learning model. He's put it into production for an inference step on new open purchase orders that might be delayed and need new predictions. And he's publishing it back out as an Ex Machina story that can be available to other users like Theo and the other supplier managers from across the world. So finally, he finishes out his pipeline, adding the various geospatial and graph visualizations that he wants to put into his story. And as a final step, he publishes this story so that other users can take action with this completely new insight, all built upon the same supply chain digital twin that is part of the C3i supply chain suite of applications, taking advantage of the various disparate aggregated data sets that are available to him in C3AI, and driving action to avoid delays and mitigation and enable mitigation options like the ones that we saw Theo take earlier. So with that, I would take the opportunity to invite you on behalf of the entire product team to join us in the Solutions Hub, where you can see more demos like the one I just shared. Thank you.